As you enter the cave, the darkness envelops you.
I have dark vision.
Moving forward, you see that this cave seems to have been carved rather than formed naturally.
Why would Soraya send us here?
Can I hear anything?
Make a perception check.
14.
You can hear something further into the cave. Something rhythmic, but hard to place due to the echo.
I want to stealth forward.
Roll stealth.
22.
Actually, everyone makes stealth checks for me.
Fuck, I have disadvantage on stealth because of my armor.
But I reach out in the darkness, and I touch Sean's shoulder, and I cast guidance. Add a d4.
Thanks, babe.
Stealth rolls.
18. 15. 13. Is that
good? you want to get high numbers?
You move forward through the cave and come upon the source of the rhythmic sound you heard earlier. There's a large, gray-skinned creature with stringy hair crouched over something in the corner. It's wearing nothing but a loincloth, and it's chewing.
I ready Eldritch Blast in case
of emergency. Oh, I cast Bark Skin on myself.
25 stone.
I unsheathe Thunder Fury, my broadsword of recompense.
Viola, what do you do? Make a decision.
Trolls like riddles, right? So maybe if we answer a riddle, then he'll tell us where the amulet is.
What?
So I will go up to the troll and say, good sir.
You walk up to a troll?
No.
Go ahead. The troll turns toward you.
We are looking for an amulet to help our friend Soraya.
Do you speak giant?
No?
Interesting. What's your AC?
12.
Eldritch Blast!
I'm sorry.
Viola?
You.
Me?
You're good at D&D. Yeah. How do I get good at D&D?
Have you slept?
I'm a grad student. I don't need sleep.
Okay. Optimization, mostly. I designed Jean to be the most effective paladin possible in 5e. They say at level 20 you become a god, but I'm gonna do it by 17.
Teach me.
I can't ask DM, she scares me.
Okay, fine. But you're gonna have to start from the basics. Otherwise, you're going to get everyone killed, and I don't have a backup character. Thank you. Spell cards. Okay. Are you ready? Aberrations are vulnerable to...
Radiant damage!
An attack of opportunity is a...
Bonus action.
Reaction! Come on! Get your head in the game!
I have astigmatism.
Then sit closer!
Thunder wave.
Evocation.
Cantrip!
Thunderclap is the cantrip, and Thunder Wave is the leveled spell.
This is not what I meant when I said I am a kinesthetic learner! I am a child of Montessori!
I don't know what that means. Undead.
Generally resistant to necrotic damage, radiant is your best bet.
Beasts.
Too many variables, but usually you can just stab them.
Good.
Okay,
I cast magic missile as my action and expeditious retreat as my bonus action so I can run away.
Can't cast two level spells in one turn.
Fuck. Okay, I cast firebolt as my action instead because it's a cantrip. Trolls regain their hit points at the beginning of their turn unless they take fire damage, which is why I will cast Scorching Ray.
Okay, and what if you're out of second level spell slots?
I'll just cast it at third level and get an additional ray.
You're ready.
So, I had a question about the amulet Soraya sent us to get.
One of you is going to have to cast Identify on it if you want details.
Wow, is this you freely giving out information about how the game works?
What are you talking about?
What you did to Viola last week?
I didn't do anything! She tried to reason with a troll. Actions have consequences.
Yeah, but she's never played D&D before, and she entered a pretty high-level game. I mean, give her some training wheels. You didn't even ask her, are you sure?
Well, she has to learn.
And instead of teaching her you're being an ass, don't be such a control freak. You're gatekeeping, which is exactly what the ex would do.
Oh, fuck, you're right.
I know I'm right. I'm always right. You should have blocked him weeks ago.
York, ask me anything about my stuff.
Okay. You've just stolen a book from a shopkeeper. The town guard is after you. What do you do?
I cast Ray of Frost to slow them down and deal damage.
Why would Viola do that?
Because I'm a wizard.
You're an enchantment wizard. Your specialty is manipulating people. Why would you immediately attack the guy?
What about optimization?
Oh, you've been talking to Jean.
Yes, optimization will make your character more powerful, but D&D is a storytelling game. What you did last session was stupid, but it was also in character. It makes sense that a wizard who specializes in charm magic would try to talk their way out of a situation.
So I should make bad decisions.
There are no bad decisions, as long as it's what your character would do. Just, you know, make sure you actually speak the language next time.
Or cast tongues.
Or cast tongues.
Our Lady Soraya, we have brought you the amulet you requested of us.
Oh, thank you, brave Yorick. I now have the final key I need to save the people of Nemis. However can I repay you?
Oh, no payment necessary.
Actually, I do need payment.
Of course.
Could I cast Detect Thoughts on Soraya?
Why?
Soraya is our friend. We literally went on this mission for her.
Yeah, but like, I don't know Soraya. And she just sent us into this dangerous cave with a troll to get some powerful artifact that does who knows what. And I want to know what she's thinking.
You're wasting a spell slot, but...
It's what my character would do. So she needs to make a DC 16 wisdom save. I would like to know her deeper thoughts.
Viola, you hear Soraya's thoughts. These idiots have played right into my hands.
No.
I now have the power to take over the city and enact my plan.
I cast Fireball.
Roll initiative.
Yes.
I just want to tell you that what you did tonight totally ruined my plans for the campaign. I have to completely rethink how I'm going to structure it because you brought on the big bad reveal so early. You've made my life hell.
I'm sorry.
And I'm proud of you. That was a smart choice. Great job. Here is your mini. This will just finish painting it.
Thank you.
What are you doing?
I am just typing up some notes.
Typical wizard. So academic.